folks, Dagan here from PMTVUK, and today I have the absolute pleasure of showcasing for you four lovely new revamped Ibanez Q Series guitars. This lovely copper metallic number I have in my hands right now for the start is the Q54M. There's also a 7-string Q547 with, as you can see, a poplar bill top, also a Q52 with a poplar bill top, and a QX52, which has the awesome slanted fret. Now with these new Q Series guitars, Ibanez haven't reinvented the wheel. It is still the same lovely Quest Series guitars we all know and love, just tweaked ever so slightly. So good that, you know. So if you're unfamiliar with Ibanez's Q Series, it's Ibanez's lovely, futuristic, lovely headless guitars. I was gonna say modern take on a classic. It is, I guess, but like so many other companies out there were doing the kind of modern headless design that Ibanez were like, you know what, we're one of the best and greatest shred guitar companies on the entire planet. Let's take a whack at it. And they kind of took all the bits from the other headless guitars around the world, improved them and put them all together in one hell of a guitar. The Ibanez Q Series guitars, 7-string, 8-string, fan fret, or whatever, are renowned the world over to be some of the most easy to play, versatile, interesting guitars on the entire planet. They're literally the easiest guitar in the world to play. They're not for everyone, I will say that, but they're designed, the contours, the ergonomics, the way the balance, the way the neck fits, this one especially with it being a QX, with the way the frets are slanted. They're not fanned frets, like you see the fans, multi-scale frets. They're fanned, so they're angled 8 degrees towards you. So I'm looking down right now, and the frets look straight, as if you were looking down at a regular guitar. So it's, you have to kind of play one to get like your head around it, but the frets are perfectly designed for where you'd have this on a strap. You see them in the hands of blues guys, fusion guys, of course, metal artists, and all the crazy shred stuff. They're just phenomenal guitars. If you've never played one before, fantastic. They come in a little case as well, a little gig bag, so you can take them away on tour and travel and play live with it just as easily and awesomely as you can do in the studio or when you're sat on the sofa watching TV. Great guitars, and they're spec'd up to the 9s too. So they all feature Nyatoh bodies. As you can see, poplar bill top on a couple of different variations, like a 7-string 54 right there. This QX52 is a metallic matte grey, and it's a great colour to showcase all the contours and stuff on this lovely little compact body. So super compact, super easy to get around, and it weighs nothing, but it's super resonant. I was almost Wonderwall, but I'm not going to play Wonderwall on this guitar. Two strap buttons as well, which is a lot of fun, depending on how you want to have the guitar up against you, I guess. It's great for standing up as well. It just stands up by itself when you put it down, lead up against something, but you can rock both. However you want to do it, that's a cool little design feature. Maple neck, as you can see, built on maple neck again with that awesome contour there, so you can get to the 24th fret, full 2-octave range, no problem at all. The 3-piece roasted maple and Bubinga neck, wizard seed profile, 20-inch radius fingerboard, so a very flat, shreddy fingerboard, and it's roasted bird's eye maple, as you can see. Those 24 frets are jumbo and stainless steel, so super smooth and you can really dig in. And the side inlays glow in the dark as well. And this is the same, these specs are the same throughout the Q Series. Up at the headstock you'll find none, besides the little gripper, the little nut, I guess, the locker nut which locks the strings in place. What is cool though is they do have a slight shoulder to them. So some guitars, some headless guitars don't have a headstock, if you can call that a headstock. So your hand slides off the end, or you can even, if you're careful, put them in Hercules hangers. Just twist it ever so slightly and it stays, it stays nice. Back down at the body, obviously because of the lack of tuners up top, with kind of the guitar's reversed, like this is the bridge, kind of, this is where the strings go. You've got the monotune Ibanez bridge, which are six individual saddles, and you tune up just by twisting this little back knob here. If anything, they're way more precise and better than your standard headstock tuners. One volume, one tone on each of them with a five-ways pickup selector and the alter switch, which changes the pickups so you get so many different voicings and stuff. I'll be here all day if I go through it, but on Ibanez's website and a picture up there tells you what the alter switch does. That's kind of all the specs. Besides, like I say, obviously besides the popular build top, the fanned fret, the slanted frets on the QX52, the seventh string and the pickups, the specs are the same. So the body woods, the bridge and the neck profile and everything are all pretty much the same. This is the Q52. With two humbuckers, the Q58 humbuckers in the neck and the bridge. So that was the Q52, obviously with the two dual humbuckers, the Q58 humbuckers, the 54. The Q54 has the Q58 humbucker in the bridge, but obviously it's HSS configuration, so there's actually R1 Ibanez single coils in the neck and the middle. I kind of feel like I've got to go. You can tell how high five those pickups are though. Anyways. that again? It's Extreme. Don't know why Extreme came out, but it did. Let's see this guy with some clean tones now. Let's hear some more 7-string tones now. That's all the side specs and sounds I can give you in this quick little rundown of the new Ibanez Q Series guitars, but I highly recommend getting yourself to your local PMT store, plugging them in and really experiencing them for yourself, because they play and feel and sound as good as they look, and boy do they look good. So let us know what you think down below in the comments, and like I say, there's a link in the description box down below which will take you to PMTonline.co.uk so you can check them out further. If you like the video, give it a thumbs up and hit subscribe. You'll find us at Play Music Today on all social media platforms. I've been Dagan, and I'll see you next time.